is going on? It is Obadiah, and today we are back. But today we're doing something a little bit different, a little bit new. We are playing on the island. Now, we haven't played on the island for, I haven't played in like 9 months. I've done no videos on the island. Because it was like the first thing that came out, we kept trying new things and it was going great. But we want to try something a little different this time. We want to make things a lot more difficult. So we are actually doing Primitive Plus. Now, I'm not going to stop doing the other things. I'm not going to stop doing the volcano. But this is going to give us an opportunity to make things harder. And to make it even harder than a normal Primitive Plus server, we're actually going with no flyers, no gigas, and I think that's it. So no flyers, no gigas, and Primitive Plus. This is not going to be a true season as we normally do. This is just going to be a couple test episodes probably, and then we're going to create an actual Primitive Plus server if we like it maybe sometime middle of January. Hey, get out of here. So this is how we're going to test. So for right now, so far everything's the same. We gather stuff up and get knocked out by cat apparently. And we're going to gather stuff up, we're going to get some building going, and kind of see how this whole deal works. I'm guessing for the first while, it's all going to be pretty much the same. Okay, so I've definitely noticed that you get different stuff. Let's see if it'll happen again. No? Okay, maybe was it with the hatchet? Stone? No? I must have been with the axe. There we go, we got clay stone! And also we got a piece of iron? So I guess instead of regular metal, it uses iron, and I don't know what the heck claystone is used for. All right, so we've got quite a little village building up here. So first things first, a bed. Get up. The bed looks awfully different. Doesn't look nearly as comfortable, except for it's got a pillow, which is nice, I guess. Storage boxes look different, and now we have this right here. This is a lumber station. So this converts wood logs to wood planks and beams. So I guess we're gonna need that to build lumber stuff. So instead of going thatch, wood, stone, there's like lumber and there's other stuff that maybe as well. So we're definitely gonna check that out. So I think you just throw the wood right in there. So I can just, yeah, just looks like it's doing it all by itself. That's fantastic. I don't think I need to learn anything for that, do I? Let's check it out. L-U-M-B for lumber. No? I thought it was called the lumber stuff. Oh, requires level 10. That's gotta be it right there. All right, what level are we? We are 8, so go ahead and pump some levels up. Let's do fortitude and health, because why the heck not? All right. We're being raided by Fiomia, or by Dilos. All we have to attack with is Fiomia. Oh, thank God. There's so many. All right, the good thing is we just were able to kill these Dilos. Now we have some fresh meat instead of raw meat, which is really interesting, and hide. I also heard that you get poultry if you kill the, Oh, that's not good. Saber. Okay, and let's get some chitin. And go ahead and throw this stuff in there. Where did they die? Oh, our poor Fiomia is dying. It's our only thing we have. We need to tame something else. All right, guys, we have got a bit of trank arrows, and I think it's time to tame something. Ooh, there's a raptor right here. That could be, what level is it? Oh, there's two. Okay, just run. Run from the raptors. We don't need to deal with that. Oh, and there's a Rex. Oh dear God, this game's so much more dangerous when you're early levels. Okay, is anything chasing me? No, because I did see these Enkis, and that's really what I wanted when I came out here for. I don't think no one's high enough to make a saddle yet. There was an 8, and this was a 12, I think. Let's go for the 12. That Rex is really making me nervous. Okay, let's see if we can draw it this way. Come on, don't go towards the Rex. Oh. Ooh, yeah, we're running. There's no way. And there's a Carno. Okay, so we might be in a bit of trouble, but let's take a look. Okay. Maybe we might have to settle for this level 8 Enki. I mean, it's still an Enki, so it'll still be, you know, useful, especially at these low levels that we're at right now. The main thing is we just don't want to die. Don't go in the water. Don't go in the water! It's in the water. Oh, and of course that's where it knocks out. Hopefully it's in shallow enough water that, oh, run! That is not gonna drown. Run. This is gonna be a much harder game because we've disabled flyers and gigas. Okay. Ooh, what's this? Ooh, explorer note. Sure, we'll take the time to go get that. Dimorphodon dossier. Okay. Oh no, is it eating my Inky? Is it? It's coming. It's coming. Okay, yeah, that sucker is right where we want to be, so I don't know if that's going to work. We've already used, like, almost half of our arrows, which is not fantastic. Because getting spoiled meat and berries and everything is kind of difficult right now. Alright, guys, I was able to get a raptor down, and now we're going to be killed by a Dilo. It's only level 12. I did knock out... That Inky, I did knock out Drowned, and then, of course, a Rex stood right on it, and nothing I could do about it. But maybe this raptor is going to be good. Oh, I'm going to die. Or we're just going to have to tame this Dilo. Ugh! Bug. Oh, there's everywhere. Okay, we just need to run at this point. We're going to have to come back and try to tame up that raptor in just a minute. Okay. Are they still chasing me? Because if I can knock out one, that would be good. Oh, there's one down. Okay, come on, come on, come on. Ugh. This one's a high level. Okay, it's running. Okay, okay. Maybe. Okay, let's try to kill the bugs. Ugh. We got broken leg. I don't think we're gonna make it. We're out of meat. We're out of food. Come on. Oh, we got it! Okay, so we can survive. Okay, there's another one. One more bug. But I think if we can survive this, then we should be good to tame up that raptor and those Dillos. We got tons of meat, but there's still one more Dillo that's not knocked out. Where was it? Did it run away? Okay, first let's go throw meat on the raptor. Is our topor still going up? No, it's going down. Okay. Now, where was that sucker? Because if that guy wakes up, we're going to be screwed. By, we don't have any narcotics or anything on us, so hopefully he'll tame up just using meat. We do have 15 times taming on, but it's not like we have any prime. Okay, let's try it. Oh, yeah, we're going to tame him. No problem. Awesome, so we got ourselves a raptor. Okay, leave him on follow. He can kind of help guide us back home. Let's go ahead and find those Dillos. I need to heal up faster. This is taking forever. There we go. All right, so we have three new tames, a raptor, two Dillos, and let's go ahead and get these suckers back to base. All right, so we have made a number of technological type advancements. So we have got... what are these, compost bins? I didn't put those. We got two lumber mills. We have made the house out of the lumber stuff, and it looks pretty cool. We've got a preserving campfire, which is, it preserves meat, I guess. So it gives it a little longer of a spoilage time, I think. But the stuff looks cool, but everything looks different with this mod, or this conversion. The beds look different. These are large storage boxes, look like kind of some shelves. And this is the smithy, which looks completely different as well. And also, I am dehydrated, and I'm going to die if I don't run down to the lake. So, yeah, everything looks definitely looks different, but it all looks really good. I think it looks better than the original vanilla stuff, for sure. But also, we now have a saddle that we can put on our raptor, so now we can actually move around and do stuff, which is fantastic. So I'm going to maybe take this guy around, do a bit of leveling, get a little meat, get a little hide, and keep advancing. It's the other guys in the tribe are working on building the building up, so I'm going to go ahead and get some other stuff. All right, we found a Diplodocus on our way, so we're going to kill it, because even though it is a much higher level and it's going to take forever to kill, it doesn't do any damage to us, so we should be able to take this sucker out. I keep having to wait for stamina to refill because my topor keeps going up from attacking with no stamina. So this is going to be not a short fight, that's for sure. This is going to be a little while. Oh, this sucker is super bloody, so any second now he should be going down, and there it is! Okay, so can we get off of our guy? I want to try to harvest it with an axe. I think I'll get more hide that way. The raptor doesn't seem to get a ton of hide when eating it. I could be wrong. Go ahead and let me know if that is the case. But 50 hide, that's not too bad with a stone hatchet. With Primitive Plus, I guess you can't put any mods on it, which is kind of a bummer. So, like, our stacking mod on whatnot's gone. So that means all this prime meat is going to be gone in just a few minutes. We did up the spoilage timer just a bit. But that's going to be... Oh, I haven't had to deal with that for a long time. Alright, so we've made a pretty long land journey, so we need to get some metal going, because using these stone tools forever is kind of a nightmare. It's actually limestone too, that's new. So we need iron, and I guess we'll take some limestone, see what the heck that's used for. Alright guys, so in this Primitive Plus thing, there are a ton of new things that I have no idea what they do. So in the smithy, you can make some new stuff. You can make a metal hammer, so let's go ahead and make one of those. A metal machete, which I've actually already made. Obsidian pickaxe, I just went and got obsidian. Beautiful. Pitchfork. And then all the regular stuff. I know there was more. There was also an obsidian... is it in here? That's a sword. There was an obsidian spear, I think? Oh, there's also an arrow. Obsidian spear. Okay, so let's check that out. A spear. Let's make two of those. And some arrows. Let's make that many. There's also fire arrows and feathered stone arrows. So how do you make the fire one? To make the fire one, you need gunpowder. So we should have plenty of charcoal. And then... do we have any spark powder? Let's check the mortar and pestle. You are in... Get out of here. spark powder. So for that, we're gonna need stone and flint. Okay, so we got flint, no problem, and stone. It looks like we are running a bit low. Ooh, let's grab feathers. We're gonna need that. Let's grab all this stuff. I don't know what any of this stuff is for. Okay, so we need some stone. Let's go ahead and grab some stone. There's gotta be a rock close by. There we go. Perfect. So we can actually try to make this stuff. I don't know what a lot of this stuff does, but we got definitely gonna have to check it out. All right, let's grab this. Let's throw the charcoal in there. And that should be able to give us some gunpowder. All right, so let's have that being made. And what else? What was the other one? So we had arrow, feathered arrow. So like four of those. We already got obsidian arrows being made. So we need to see the flaming arrow. Okay, come on. Ah, it's taking too long. Gunpowder. There we go. Perfect. And we need one per, so there's five. So we can go ahead and test all this stuff out. All right, so we have also picked up limestone, which says, oh, that's not what I'm looking for. Hold on, how about the carbon? Carbon, unrefined carbon, and you can refine it in a forge. So let's go ahead and throw that in there and see what that turns into while we do this. So I went ahead and made a training dummy. Let's go ahead and lay this sucker down. Let's just throw it right here. This looks like a good spot for a training dummy to me. Perfect. Now, we know the stuff in the training dummy is not always 100% accurate, but it does give us a good idea of things. So, let's test out the arrows first. And throw it in there. Okay, and let's go right in the middle of that target, or close enough. And it did not register. Does not register. Okay, we're gonna have to go shoot something in the wild. Okay, so we found a stego to test this on. I'm hoping this is high enough that we can avoid getting hit. Ooh, that would be better. But I don't know if we can get up there. So let's just try here. So this is the obsidian arrow. 95 damage. That's not so bad. Why is he running away? I hit him one time. Okay, well, he's doing his runaway thing. Let's try the feathered arrow. And see how that goes. Are you going to come back? Or are you just literally just going to run away forever? Oh, now he's coming back. Ugh. Okay, get back on the rock. Okay, no, he just de-aggroed. Or is he still running? What is going on with the AI recently? It's like out of control. Okay, so this is the feathered arrow. 75, oh, okay, now he's coming. Run! All right. Okay, so let's see if we can. Oh, he's pretty slow, so we should be able to get back on our rock, no problem. I'm hoping this is tall enough. Okay, let's test it out. Uh-oh. Ooh. Oh, nope, not tall enough. Not tall enough at all. Okay, I guess we'll de-aggro him. So far the obsidian arrow is light years better than... can we get up? Than the feathered arrow. So 75 to 25 is a pretty big difference. Oh, he's right there. So that rock would have been terrible anywho. Well, now I just think I'm gonna have to kill this guy. Okay, let's try quickly put the flaming arrow on. And run. And we'll test this out next. Okay, get far enough ahead. Ooh, that might have been a headshot though. We need a body shot to really check. And also I didn't see any actual flames, which is a little bit disappointing. Okay, body shot. Missed. 60. So not really the best, and it says flaming, but I see no flames. Not one flame. Oh, there we go. When it was in the air, it was on fire. Did you see that? Oh, yeah. Okay, cool. Is that all the arrows? Or are we missing something? No? Well, I guess let's just take this guy out with the obsidian, because that was definitely the best one of the bunch. Oh, he looks like he's almost dead. I guess we'll leave. Oh, no. Oh, no, 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 no. Come on. Head on fight. And he's done. Oh, it was level 4. No wonder. It was so easy to kill. Okay, so I'm gonna head back to base. Actually, you know what? Let's check out some of these hand tools. So, we know that a pick is really good for breaking rocks, getting flint and stone. How does the obsidian pick do? Okay, stone and claystone. Okay, I don't know what claystone is used for yet. Okay, what about against trees? 4 wood, 20 thatch. And this just gets... let's try another one. Okay, so this definitely gets... is that better? Compared to this? No, it feels like the obsidian pickaxe does not do as good. Yeah, so I guess it's just for the claystone? Okay, well, at least we have a tool to get whatever we need that for. Now, I believe that the hammer doesn't harvest, does it? No, can we knock down trees with it? It's meant for knocking things out, not for harvesting. All right, there's a Dilo right here, and we're gonna go beat him in the head with a hammer. Come here. Get knocked out! So I'm pretty sure they're supposed to be able to knock out Dino, kind of like a club does. But also there's supposed to be a better club. So it wasn't super effective. I mean, it worked and did very little damage. So I guess for small dinos, it could work, but I don't know. It doesn't seem amazing. Oh, that's bad. Oh, never mind. Hold on. Run. Okay. Saber. Let's just kill this sucker. Oh, is he stuck right there? Ha, suck my fire arrows. I wonder if it actually does burn damage. Oh, now you want to run, huh? All right, obsidian arrows next. Where'd he go? Where'd you run off to, little buddy? Oh, he's way far away. Okay, is he gonna come back? Yeah, here he goes. Come on. Come on, it's taking forever. Okay, be stuck. Oh, you're not stuck this time. You most certainly are not. Ha ha, we got him, all right. Okay, so let's see now. So while I wait for that Dilo to wake up, we also have this machete, which I don't really know what it doesn't harvest. I already tested, didn't harvest hide well. How does this do? So that's definitely gets more meat. I don't know, these things aren't very clear what they do. Oh, well, this one is. It says collect specialized stone resources from rocks, okay. So we know those. This one primarily used for taming dinosaurs, so not good for gathering. We also have a pitchfork, which is a pitchfork. But the cool thing is you can throw it, and you can throw it pretty dang far. Look at it go. Watch it go. It goes, are we gonna clear the river? We did not clear the river. Okay, so we got a pitchfork. You also have obsidian spears. And we'll go ahead and test that out on, you can throw these too, right? Oh, and it went through the ground. Oh no, it's right there. Can we pick it up? And we'll go test those out on a training dummy. Is this guy ever gonna wake up? Holy crap. All right, so if he's not gonna wake up, should I just wait? I'm just gonna wait the rest of the time. All right, this Dilo's about to wake up, and then we're gonna knock it right back out using the club. What's the net? Come on. Oh, there we go. Let's see if it feels better. Oh no. Go to sleep. Go to sleep. So this seems to not be working as good as the hammer did. It's... Oh, now it's running. Oh, but I can't see. I don't know what I'm running into. There we are. Come on. Oh. Don't run away from me. Yeah, so I feel like there was a Rex over here, so please don't run this far. So the hammer definitely works better than the club, at least in real life usage. But we can go ahead and... hey, you know what? This is a good time to test the Obsidian Spear. How much damage does it do? 48. Into the head. Compared to the pike, which does... Ah! Okay, we're running away from a raptor. All right, we gotta get back to base, to a more controlled environment, continue testing this stuff out, and then I'll bring you back. All right, so we are back at base, and we are gonna test this stuff out on the training dummy. Why does the training dummy not work? What the heck? Hold for options. Demolish. Well, this is garbage. And friendly fire is currently turned off, so we can't attack things. Ah! Okay, well, may not be able to do the test I wanted, but we can at least check them out. So we've got the pitchfork, which is pretty cool. We've got obsidian spears, and that's the wrong button, which is, it looks an awful lot like a spear compared to, the pike, spear, pitchfork, machete, club, hammer, of course we know the hatchet, and the pickaxe, and the pick. So there is all sorts of new stuff, and I think there's probably more that I haven't even seen. I think there's also like a skinning knife and all sorts of cool stuff. Oh, and so what did that carbon turn into? Steel. Interesting. Okay, so there's all sorts of new stuff for us to play with, and we're going to kind of work our way through it and figure out what all this stuff does and what it's for and how the whole deal works. But for today, guys, I do think that is going to be it. I know there's a lot of stuff that we looked at and a lot of kind of chaotic running around, getting things set up for the first time on a new server. Now tomorrow we should be back playing on the volcano again. This is just something we're going to do a few times until we decide if we actually want to set up a Primitive Plus server as well. So if you guys are interested in seeing that, let me know. Before today, like I said, that is going to be it. If you did enjoy the video or if you learned something, do me a favor and hit that thumbs up button. And of course, if you have not done so already, please feel free to subscribe and share and the whole deal. Also, you can hit me up on all your social medias, your Twitter, your Instagram, your Facebook, your Google Plus, and even though nobody uses it. And of course, you can check out my Patreon at patreon.com/ObediahX. But I really do appreciate you guys coming to hang out with me today. And until next time, I will see you later.